Service for today is found in the Pentecost Memorial Day booklet. I'll announce the pages as we move along. We'll begin on page 1. Alleluia, Christ is risen.
The Lord is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Song of Praise is found on page 11, the National Hymn, verses 1, 3, and 4. Ventured much for the liberties we now enjoy. Grant that we may not rest until all the people of this land share the benefits of true freedom and gladly accept its discipline. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Please be seated. A reading from the second book of Maccabees, beginning at the 38th verse of the 12th chapter. Then Judas assembled his army and went to the city of Adullam. As the seventh day was coming on, they purified themselves according to the custom and kept the Sabbath there. On the next day, as had now become necessary, Judas and his men went to take up the bodies of the fallen and to bring them back to lie with their kindred in the sepulchres of their ancestors. So they all blessed the ways of the Lord, the righteous judge who reveals things that are hidden. And they turned to supplication, praying that the sin that had been committed might be wholly blotted out. The noble Judas exhorted the people to keep themselves free from sin, for they had seen with their eyes what had happened as a result of sin to those who had fallen. He also took up a collection, person by person, to the amount of 2,000 drachmas of silver, and sent it to Jerusalem to provide for a sin offering. In doing this, He acted very well and honorably, taking account of the resurrection. For if he were not expecting that those who had fallen would rise again, it would have been superfluous and foolish to pray for the dead. But if he was looking to the splendid reward that is laid up for those who have fallen asleep in godliness, it was a holy and pious thought. Therefore he made atonement for the dead, so that they might be delivered from their sins. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
A non-scriptural reading. In Flanders fields the poppies grow, between the crosses row on row that mark our place. In the sky the larks, still bravely singing, fly, scarce heard amid the guns below. We're the dead short days ago, who lived, felt dawn, saw sunset glow, loved and were loved, and now we die in Flanders fields. Take up our quarrel with the foe, to you from failing hands we throw the torch, be yours to hold it high. If you break faith with us who die, we shall not sleep though poppies grow in Flanders fields.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John.
Glory to you, O Christ.
Jesus said, "Everything that the Father gives to me will come to me, and anyone who comes to me I will never drive away. For I have come down from heaven not to do my own will, but the will of him who sent me. And this is the will of him who sent me, that I should lose nothing of all that he has given me, but raise it up on the last day. This is indeed the will of my Father, that all who see the Son and believe in him may have eternal life, and I will raise them up on the last day." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Please be seated for the reading of the memorial list, which is that prepared for 2019. We pray for those who died in service to the nation, for Corporal Russell Wilcox, who died in the Flanders field, for Ernest Fletcher, who died in the invasion of Sicily, for George Harrison, Robert Stoats, and Fred Pine. We pray for all departed veterans, remembering especially those who have been enrolled in this year's list. We begin with prayers for Elisha Lawrence Jr., who served faithfully in the Continental Army and is interred at the Christ Church Cemetery here in Allentown. We pray for Alexander Bean, Robert Bean, Joseph Cormier, Michael Calandrello, Henry Bourgeois, Ernest J. Hafer, Jr., Ted Biger, Bruce Kinter, William Embley, Frank Bennett, Robert Sustick, James Ellis, Arthur Collinson, William Malkin, Sr., William Malkin, Jr., Henry Pasden, Ralph Napolitan, Ernest Malcolm, William E. Malkin, William Jennings, David Jennings, Frank Godowski, Daniel Halpin, Robert McCormick, Herbert Bass, Francis McGee, Claire B. King, Russell Coyne, Frank Schnorbis, Russell Temple Jr., Clark Perry Sr., Arthur Perry Sr., John McKee, Charles Smith, Charles Voorhees Jr., Andrew Schwing, Bill Danbury, Charles Wright, Frank Jennings, Douglas Saley, Herbert Schmidt, Jack W. Jennings, Joseph Cahill Kane, Warren Latarola, John Tartaglia, Daniel Bozer, Robert P. Pownell, Henry Bozarth, Norman T. Peet, Frank T. Peet, Kosh Miller Jr., Bud King, Maurice Iington, Edwin Forkell, William Greenlee, Fred Niss, Francis McGee, James Murray, Earl P. Vickers, Nathan Rutnam, Robert Anatuccio, Joseph D. Pownall III, Robert Rhodes, William Rhodes, Arthur Cooper, William Mendocino, Edward R. Muller, Charles Mustick, Fred Gerhauser Jr., Joseph J. Harity Sr., Timothy Eisner, Samuel Johnson, Eric G. Gessel, Burke B. Lieb, Deacon, Walter Diamond, Charles A. Gravener, Floyd Gravener, Arthur Gravener, Ronald Gravener, William Brown Jr., George Chambers, James Emmaus, Joseph R. Matthews, William Howard Wilkinson, Isaac Freyer, Russell Sutton, Thomas Sutton, Gerald Crowe, for Arthur Greenlove, Arthur Greenlee, Samuel Johnson, Atkinson Poser, Brian Belt Linder, Mark Colby, Robert Sustick, Robert Chiffray, Thomas Simpson Jr., Charles E. Durham, Raymond Knight, Alana Holdren, John Ferguson, Arthur Hobson Sr., William Perkins, Al Gernhardt, John Manella, Richard Dyson Priest, George Dixon, Samuel C. Johnson, Norman Leap, Nicholas Smith, Walter A. Blair, Russell Gravener, William Comerford, Lee Gravener, James Clayton, George Balog, Carl H. Zur Sr., Lawrence Kenneth Powell Sr., Russell L. Sutton Sr., Martin Munchen, Ronald Swartz, Midge Sutton, Russell Sutton. May they rest in peace, and may life perpetual shine upon them. May their souls and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy and kindness of God, rest in peace. Amen. Please stand if you are able. The service continues with the prayers of the people found on page 12. On this day, our memories may be so painful that we cannot live with them. Yet we dare not live without them. Let us pray that we may never forget, but always remember before God, that in his sight war is evil, and that to all who experience it, war is hell. For leaders who sent the young to war, that their judgment may be sound and their motives be pure, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For soldiers who lay down their lives for others, that the love which inspires their sacrifice may be fulfilled in the love of Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For soldiers who have been maimed or brutalized by war, that our love for them may make their scars of no consequence, and make their brutality yield to the tenderness of returning love, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have been left behind, that they may live on the strength of those and the love that they knew, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who suffer most from war, that the homeless, the orphaned, the hungry, and the innocent may help us to turn from warlike ways to accept God's gift of peace, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, in whose hand are the living and the dead, we give you thanks for all your servants who have laid down their lives in the service of our country. Grant to them your mercy and the light of your presence, and give us such a lively sense of your righteous will that the work which you did begin in them may be made perfect. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. Amen. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Be seated. This time we'll have special music for Memorial Day. service continues with a great thanksgiving as found on page 6. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give him thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father, Almighty Creator of heaven and earth, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who rose victorious from the dead and comforts us with the blessed hope of everlasting life. For to your faithful people, O Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when our mortal body lies in death, there is prepared for us a dwelling place eternal in the heavens. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. We give thanks to you, O God, for the goodness and love which you have made known to us in creation, in the calling of Israel to be your people, in your word spoken through the prophets, and above all in the word made flesh, Jesus, your Son. For in these last days you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him you have delivered us from evil and made us worthy to stand before you. In him you have brought us out of error, into truth, out of sin, into righteousness, out of death, into life. On the night before he died for us, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread, and when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, according to his command, O Father, we remember his death. We proclaim his resurrection, we await his coming in glory, and we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, O Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray you, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant, united to your Son in his sacrifice, that we may be acceptable through him, being sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, put all things in subjection under your Christ, and bring us to that heavenly country, where with the ever-blessed Virgin Mary, James, Matthias, Martin, Cornelius, George, Joan of Arc, Florence Nightingale, and all your saints, we may enter the everlasting heritage of your sons and daughters. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation. By him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ hath taught us, we are bold to pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Alleluia. Christ, our Passover, is sacrificed for us.
Therefore let us keep the feast. Alleluia.
Let us pray. My Jesus, I believe that you are truly present in the blessed sacrament of the altar. I desire to offer you praise and thanksgiving as I proclaim your resurrection. I love you above all things and long for you in my soul. Since I cannot receive you in the sacrament of your body and blood, come spiritually into my heart. Cleanse and strengthen me with your grace, Lord Jesus, and let me never be separated from you. May I live in you and you in me in this life and in the life to come. The gift of God for the people of God. The body of Christ for God's heaven. Service continues with hymn 358, found on page 14, verses 1, 2, and 3. Post-communion prayer is also found on page 14. Let us pray. Lord God, our Father, we pledge ourselves to serve you and all mankind in the cause of peace, for the relief of want and suffering, and for the praise of your name. Guide us by your Spirit. Give us wisdom. Give us courage. Give us hope. And keep us faithful. Now and always. Amen. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you this day and always. Amen. Let us go forth in the name of Christ. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia.
The closing hymn is found on page 15. Mine eyes have seen the glory.